So bring him incense, gold and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to own him. The King of Kings salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing.
So we have prepared for the darshan, where the Mexicans first can ask questions of Lonello and Claire de Lee. Before the first question, they would like to speak just a little bit on one particular subject. And Lonello says this is the virtue of innocence. We heard in this song the revering of the child, Jesus. The most innocent of beings who have probably embodied upon earth, in the sense that he was pure, undefiled, holy, and he had a mission of light to bring the Christ consciousness to mankind and to share the great teachings on mercy and forgiveness and love and compassion and kindness in the Piscean dispensation that brought people out of the throes of a society that had been satiated with a preponderance of focus on the law and rules and regulations in the Jewish tradition at the time. He brought back an understanding of the nature of true love, even universal love, divine love, pure love. And this love flows from the innocence and the purity of the Divine One, who is completely pure. God is the most innocent of all beings in the creation. And really, in one sense, there's only one being in the universe, God, and we are all part of God. Yet, because God has given us free will, we've unfortunately entered into a disassociated state of identification with the human or the temporal, the human personality. And so it behooves us to return to an understanding of our own innocence, our own pure state of being within God's eternal being. When we can have the sense of our own innocence, as the child Jesus had it in the creche on that pivotal day in cosmic history for the earth when he was born into this world, we too can have the sense of our own Christ awareness, the purity of our inner being, the divine essence of who we are and were created in the beginning. And when we revel in, or at least revere, this inner innocence, which innocence really means inner sense, the inner sense of our soulfulness in God and as a part of God and always in the presence of God, then everything becomes mystical, magical, and miraculous, because we, like Jesus, are in that divine estate of beingness in the heart of God. So at Christmas time, when we revere the Christ child, hopefully we're also revering the child of God within ourselves, our true nature, our inner child, which is innocent and pure, undefiled and holy. This is the way we were created, and this is the way we can choose to remain, even as adults, being childlike, being loving, kind, understanding, patient, pure, and virtuous in every possible way, seeking God within everyone, seeking to see the divine within every situation, the divine opportunity for self-transcendence and beauty and harmony to be pervaded and expressed through our lives and what we do, what we think, what we feel, how we emote. All of these things can come from an inner spring of purity and innocence. And when we see ourselves in this mode of living, like the innocent, beautiful child who is there, all light, all love, on Christmas morn, then we too can rise into that same universal Christ spirit that he bore within his being and shared with humanity. So as we move toward Christmas Day, and before that, to the winter solstice, we can feel the impelling divine energy of this opportunity to live a pure life, a sweet life, a holy life, as a son or daughter of God. Remembering who we are, each one of us a son or daughter of God, no less than or greater than Jesus was, we're all created equally in the eyes of God. We all have that self-same essence of God's eternal spirit inside of us.